Instagram unit, it's your girl Jackie, and today I have what ended up being, it was like an accidental tutorial. I actually had no intention of doing a tutorial, and I got this hot pink lip gloss that I just absolutely love from Smashbox, and I was trying to come up with a look that would look good with the lip gloss, and then I was kind of practicing for a tutorial that I'm doing in a couple days, and I just ended up putting together this look that I just love, and I was like, you know what, I have to do a tutorial today. So here it is, the accidental tutorial. Ever notice how sometimes when you do something on a whim, it comes out way better than something you had been planning for like weeks? This is one of those occasions. But anyways, I am so happy with this look. I love it so much. Most of the products that I'm using, I've been getting a lot of emails from you guys saying, oh, you know, you only use really pricey products that I can't afford. The thing is, I'm just using what I have, and that's what I always tell you guys to do. Use what you have, and that's why I will describe the color to you. That way, you don't have to use the particular brand that I'm using. You can always buy something similar at the drugstore, or like I said, just use what you have. Mix a couple colors if you have to. So anyways, I hope you guys like the look as much as I do. Keep the requests coming. Stay tuned because I have another purple look coming up and a couple more things. So I will talk to you guys soon and I hope you're having a great weekend. Okay, so I've already applied my primer and I used, of course, same thing I always use, the Urban Decay Primer Potion in Sin, especially because I'm working with neutral colors and this is a neutral color and it has like a really nice pearlescent base. It's just gonna really set off the highlight colors that I'm gonna put on. All over shadow brush by Sephora. I'm gonna pick up some of my highlight color and I'm using, of course, the Too Faced Natural Eye Kit, which I pretty much use every single day. And I'm going to use the color Silk Teddy. This is like a really nice kind of champagne color. Put this starting at the crease and just going up into the brow bone. Okay, so now using a dome shader brush. I don't know why, for some reason I really like to use this for lid colors just because it's really good for pressing the color into the lid and making it look a little bit brighter. I'm going to pick up a light gold shimmery color. This is from the Brown Eyes Kit by Pop. I'm just going to use this light gold color right there. Kind of looks like maybe like Midnight Cowboy from Urban Decay, that kind of gold color. Just use whatever you have, and that's kind of what I'm doing basically, is just using whatever I have. But I'm going to pick up some of this onto the brush and I'm going to put it onto the lid area. And I'm going to focus on the inner corner also. Okay, now I'm going to pick up a little bit more color and I'm going to put it on the inner half of my lower lash line. Okay, and now using a loose eyeshadow by Sugar Pill Cosmetics, this is what it looks like right here. This color is called Goldilocks. I'm gonna try to show it to you guys without. It's just a really beautiful gold shimmer. So I'm going to pick up a really, really small amount of that, just because this is really, really highly pigmented, so you don't need very much product. So I'm just gonna pick up a little teeny tiny bit. And I'm gonna dab that over the light gold eyeshadow that I just put on, and this is gonna really make it pop a lot. Now, if you wanted to have it super bright, say it's a nighttime look, then you can really pack it on. I just did it kind of lightly because it's only evening. If I was going out to a club or something, I would put a lot more on there because this is super, super sparkly. So I'm just gonna dab that on over the gold. And I'm gonna go underneath the lash line as well, just like I did with the light gold. Okay, now that that's done, I'm going to pick up a brown shimmery color. This one is Cocoa Puff, again, in the Too Faced Natural Eye Kit. Let me just get it close so you guys can see. It's kind of like a medium brown color with a little bit of gold glitter in it, but not too much because we've got a lot of glitter going on there with the gold. So even if you wanted to use a flat brown color with no glitter in it, that would be good too. So I'm going to pick up some of this, and I'm using an eyeshadow blender brush by The Body Shop. I'm going to pick up some of this, and I'm going to put this on the outer corner. And then I'm going to blend it up into the crease. Okay, now that the eyeshadow is done, I don't know if you guys can see, but I've had a lot of fallout from some of the gold glitter that I put on there. So I'm just going to take a piece of good old tape and I'm going to wrap it around my fingers. Just like that. And I'm just gonna kind of run it or dab it over my cheeks and it'll kind of pick up some of that excess glitter. Okay, so now I'm going to curl my eyelashes and apply some mascara. Those of you who are new to my videos, you might not know, I always do that step first just because I find that when I curl my eyelashes, I tend to take off some of the eyeliner that I had just put on. So I just kind of do that step first. You do it any way you want, that's just the way I do it. So I'm gonna do that and then I'll be right back because you guys pretty much know how to curl eyelashes and put on mascara. So I'll be right back. Okay, so now taking a liquid eyeliner, I'm going to use Liner Intense in Carbon Black by L'Oreal. This is, you guys know, my absolute favorite eyeliner ever. I'm going to draw a medium thickness line across the top, lash line. I'm going to start thin, as you can see what I did right here. I'm going to start thin and just get thicker as I make my way out. Not quite winging it, I'm just bringing it straight out, because then once I put that bottom eyeliner on, it's going to meet and create a little point without creating too much of a wing. Okay, so now taking an Infallible Retractable Never Fail Eyeliner by L'Oreal. This is in Carbon Black also. I'm going to see how I went ahead and sharpen that. So I'm going to take that and I'm going to fill in my waterline. And I'm going to start just drawing kind of like a sharp line right here. And then going inward and bringing it all the way across until I connect these two lines right here. Okay, now taking the same eyeliner, I'm going to do the same thing to the upper waterline. Now, if you have sensitive eyes, you can go ahead and skip this step. I do it because it really fills in the gaps and it makes it look almost like you have false eyelashes on. So I'm just going to do that really quickly. And we are done with the eyes. I told you guys that was going to be easy, right? That's like one of the easiest looks I've ever done, and honestly, it's one of my favorites. So, for the rest of the look, what I have on my cheeks, I started, of course, with my killer combination of Benefit Dallas and, let me hold that the right way for you. So Benefit Dallas and Throb. So Dallas is a darker color, so I put that on my cheeks first to give me like a nice contour. And then I follow it with Throb, which is like a really nice shimmery pink, because then that's going to give it like a really nice shimmer and it's going to kind of highlight the pink on my lips. So, for the lips, which are a super duper important part of this look, I used, as a lip liner, I used Urban Decay 24/7 Pencil in Envious. This is a really, really nice deep hot pink. As you can see, I wear this color often, and I need to restock very badly. But, yeah, this is just a gorgeous, gorgeous color. So, I lined the lips, and then I did like a thick line, and then I took a blender brush and I just kind of blended it in a little bit. That way I didn't want like a harsh line to overtake what the gloss was going to look like. So then I went over that with Smashbox Lip Shine in Berry Hot. This is from the new Heartbreaker line. This is from their spring line. I actually had been looking at this at Ulta for a while and didn't, I don't know, it didn't do much for me. So I just kind of decided against getting it. And then I saw Andrea's Choice, who's one of my favorite gurus on here, did a look using this, and I thought it looked absolutely gorgeous, so I had to go get it after I saw it on her, and oh my god, I love it so much. It's just this really nice hot pink, and what I like is that it's really easy to adjust. If you want it to look a little less hot and just like a little more like a carnation pink or something, you can just use a lighter lip liner. I use a darker color because you guys know me, I like to be flashy. So anyways, that guys, so much for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye. So that does it for the eyes. Now for the rest of the look on my cheeks. Hello? Hey, Ron. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's not raining here yet, though. Yeah, but they already knew you were a jackass on a cell phone, so I don't think it matters. All right. Okay. Bye. Jesus, Mary and Joseph.